You call all the department people and allow them to represent the problem. If you create such an opportunity, I am very sure many will start crying in that meeting because they face a whole lot of problems. Only thing is they want their problems to be heard. You create such an opportunity. Right at the end of the meeting, you will have a list of issues in your hand. Am I correct? That is called issue hopper. And then you prioritize and then you proceed. And now coming to CTQ and CTB. Okay, just to help you understand CTQ and CTB. See here, vaccination is given. Nowadays, vaccination has become, you know, a daily activity. Everywhere you can see. Crores and crores of people are getting vaccinated. But the vaccination we all did the vaccination. I think we all felt comfortable. Suppose imagine we don't feel comfortable. And the vaccination manufacturer or the doctor who are giving the vaccination, they are given a task. When you give the vaccination, it should not be painful. Now, this is the task given as a green belt to you. Now tell me, how will you work further? Or how will you create what kind of problem statement you will write now? All of you get my question? Vaccination is nowadays, you know, lots and lots of campaign going on everywhere. But with the pilot study, you got the input. People are crying when the vaccination is given. Do you continue? You can't continue, isn't it? You have to make some changes. And now tell me, how will you create a project charter now? Or what will be your problem statement now? I want you to react now, all of you. What will you do? Or let us simplify the case. Let's say the person or the customer is a small kid. Smaller kids are also given vaccination. You can see them always crying, isn't it? I don't want to see children crying while vaccinations are done.
Okay, we can go for some painless needles.
Painless?
Painless needles.
Wow, beautiful. Very good. Can you go deeper for that? Make it actionable.
So in acupuncture, there's a device called patch. So in that patch, some micro pores will be there. When we attach the patch to that kid, it will not feel the pain. And that way we can reduce the pain. And within the patch, there are some kind of ingredients of this patch.
Very good. You deserve a big round of applause. Fantastic thinking.
Thanks.
And suppose I don't want to go for that thinking. I have a limitation that I need to work only with the current system. I can't switch from the existing system to a newer one. Like the patch and all, no, I don't want to bring in to my thing. And I don't want to go for a oral kind of medication also. I want to continue with the same system by reducing the problem. Now, what could be
the changing the way by giving education to the vaccinator, that if it is kid like giving chocolates, diverting them at the time of pain, they don't realize the pain. So such kind of guidance is
good idea.
Yeah.
Good idea. So yeah. CK Prasad has given a very good idea. Give chocolates. Maybe you want to give Cadbury's, Kit Kat.
Yeah.
And these kind of chocolates. Yes. I'll keep it one option. And again, we'll come to that. And anyone else would like to suggest how to make it actionable?
Sir, we can use this. Doctor or nurse will be experienced. One who have a very good experience to inject. And also, they have to talk to a child, I mean, with the small kids, like just what they like, what they, you know, interest, how so we can make the fun, make some fun out some.
Very good. So you want to make the doctors tell some stories and then
make stories and jokes.
Make a song.
And also,
hello. These kind of things. Yes. Then.
Hello. Yeah. Hello. Am I audible?
Yes, you're audible.
Yeah, so we can make a separate kids room for kids vaccination. We can have a separate kids room where there is a audiovisual or cartoons, you know, surrounded on the walls or some toys to play, which would divert the attention. The angle of injection also can be a thought.
Wow, angle of injection. Very good. I like this way of looking at the problem. The angle with which the injection is given. That could be a source of pain. Very good. So all of you have given a nice idea, but please tell me, are you really solve the problem or you wanted to amplify the problem?
Solve the problem or minimize the
Yeah, are you really trying to solve the problem or you are trying to invite new problems? By giving chocolate and biscuits and then trying to sing in front of the child, trying to dance in front of the child. Sometimes when we sing, the child may cry more. Because we are not professional singers or storytellers, isn't it? You are making a doctor a storyteller, you are making a doctor a singer. Sometimes this is also a problem also. We need to be very, very careful that we actually attack the real pain metric. But I liked the answer given by Natarajan as well as to some extent, the angle of the process, the way the angle at which you keep the, the syringe and the needle. That could be a source of pain, whether it should be perpendicular or it should be at 45 degree. But that's a good way of looking at what is actually making the patient painful for your child. Can I say it is the needle size? Can I say it is the thickness of the needle that is the source of pain experienced by the child? Can you do something on that instead of singing and dancing and giving chocolates? Can you do something on that? The needle thickness is 0.5 mm. Can I make it 0.25? When I make it 0.5 to 0.25, will the pain come down? Yes? Yes or no?
Yes.
So this is called CTQ identification. An actionable metric. It may be just one metric or it may be multiple metric. And now you may start realizing that giving chocolates and then playing some audio visuals and all those things are actually inviting new problems, not actually helping solve the current. Considering the limitations we have, we want to work with the same system. But the Natarajan suggestion for going for a completely a new thing is the redesign of the process. Redesign of the process is called DFSS. Design for Six Sigma. Now we are now talking about Six Sigma projects. So the baby cries uncontrollably whenever an injection should be. It is because the size of the needle causes the pain. It could be the thickness or the diameter, or it could be the length. These are the duration with which the injection process is happening. All the three are measurable. Am I correct?
Work
on these things. This is called CTQ. Right? This is called CTQ, and some color codings are indicated. To avoid problems. This is a lean approach. Why color coding? Different colors, different size. Right? The lower size is this one. You can see. Probably kids will get this. To try to go for make still much better kind of needles, that will actually reduce. So this is called CTQ identification. And now the child problem is understood. CTQ is identified. Now there is a business problem. The needle size was reduced from 0.5 to 0.25. But now inside the 0.25, medicine should flow. Am I correct? And so I must drill a hole inside that 0.25 mm. Now this becomes a business problem now. Outer diameter is painful to the children and inner diameter is painful to the business. If you keep me smaller and smaller hole, how will I make the injection to flow? And that too should finish faster. So voice of customer is converted into CTQ, which is the outer diameter of the needle. And voice of business is converted into CTB, which is the inner diameter of the needle. If both are achievable, a business happens. Both are achievable, business happens, quality gets the birth. Otherwise, there will be a quality gap. Got it? To capture the voice of the customer, it is important to collect data from a large representative sample of target customer base. To collect the data, Six Sigma practitioners can use government record, surveys and questionnaires, census data, can refer to case studies. And what is your option here? To understand your customer better, what could be the best option? Everything can be an option, but question is, what could be the best option?
Survey and questionnaire. Yes.
Very good, beautiful. You are thinking perfectly, right? Talk to the specific customer segment. Case study may sometimes be from a different segment, and then the old records and data may not reflect the current reality. So this is the best tool: surveys and questionnaires. So project identification, you can identify based on voice of customer analysis. You know now what is voice of customer analysis. Talk to your customers. You also know voice of business analysis. But you know what is voice of business analysis? The voice of the leaders, not the employees. Employees are internal customer, but leaders, leaders' voice are voice of business. Cash conversion cycle is not the voice of every employee. It's the voice of the MD, right? So such painful metrics of your leaders or management people is called voice of business. Listen to them. Their pain is also important. That also deserves some healing. And then one more thing which can directly reflect the problem is cost of poor quality. So convert everything into either a CTQ or CTB. CTQ means what? Critical to quality. CTB means what? Critical to business. When I say CTQ, it is related to the effectiveness. When I say CTB, it is mostly related to the efficiency. It may be related to effectiveness also, but mostly the management people will be concerned about the efficiency. Whether you lag in terms of effectiveness or you lag in terms of efficiency, you will be wasting money. Am I correct? That's called cost of poor quality, right? Express, you measure all the three, and then if all those values are not at the desirable level, that is an improvement opportunity. Improvement opportunity is nothing but the project. Now, do you see, you have a list of projects? Got it? And now you have an issue hopper. So many projects. Every project, the saving potential in lakhs of rupees. This particular project has a saving potential of 900 lakhs in 1 year. Always benefits are calculated on annual basis.
And sir, can you take the slide one level behind for a moment? Okay, sir. Thank you.
And availability of data, the consequence of the project, other functions concerned about the problem, maybe other departments. And is this problem is going to be part of some existing project and other remarks. Like this, you can create a list, and then this list can be handed over to the team which is performing step number two, which is prioritization. Right now, this is a list issue hopper. And now you can prioritize based on your organization's KPIs. And those KPIs will represent the strategy goals. So I will stop here for your debate, and then we'll continue.